So I want to talk about a little bit of the difference between how the coordinate system works in a Swiss machine as compared to a conventional lathe. A conventional lathe uses local coordinates, whereas a Swiss lathe uses global coordinates. And most people are familiar with the local coordinates, so I'm kind of going to explain how that works first and then explain how a Swiss machine utilizes global coordinates in just a little bit different way. So on a conventional lathe, local coordinates are G54 to G59 work shifts. So you could have up to six different work shifts. For example, a work shift would be every machine has a home reference position. And that's represented in this drawing by dots. So you have a dot here and a dot here. So this would be Z reference position. Older machines, you'd have to do a reference return in the morning, do a zero return, it brings you back to reference position. All a local coordinate does, G54 to G59, is shifts from that reference position. It gives you a new zero for a certain axis, whether you choose X, Y, or Z, or any other axis. It references from the home position. So let's say this is my chuck and this is my part. If I brought my tool up and measured here and said G54 Z0, it's gonna set a shift amount in Z axis for G54 from this position. So the number that comes in is always gonna be from reference position. So you can do that G55, G56, G57, G58, and G59, all different Z values. So let's say halfway through your part program, you got a longer part, you need to come up and you pull material out to a new location. So if this is your starting point in G54, and this is your Z0, now you pull the material out to here. So now you have a new coordinate system, G55, maybe it's G56, with this new Z0 plane. So you can shift this as you go with different coordinate systems or with different local coordinates. What a Swiss does is you can do the same thing and you can shift it 100 times if you wanted to, just every time. A Swiss does not use G54 through G59. It does not use these, okay? So what it does is it always uses the reference position. It uses one coordinate system. You're always in G54 and it's machine position, home position. So when you do a measurement, let's say we pulled out a part and you fed out a little bit further and you want a new Z0. All you would do is G50, Z, where is the new location? So you can G50 shift the axis and that's the new position. When you're done at the end of the program, you would send it home, G28, W0, and then you can G50 shift Z0. And it resets to the actual machine position. You can also shift relatively from the last place. So for example, in this distance would be G54, and this is G55. What I would do here on a Swiss machine, this would be my normal Z0 at the beginning of my program. If I wanted to feed out this distance, I could say G50 W minus the amount that I actually fed my material out. And now it's basically gonna do the same thing as this. It's gonna set the same coordinate system. So I can say G50 W minus. That's gonna be the relative distance from here to here. How much did I move from my standard Z0? I would shift that amount. When I'm all done, and I wanna go back to my normal Z0, beginning of the next part, I would say G50W, no minus, back the same amount. So let's just call this 1 inch, and we're gonna say also 1 inch. So whatever I shift out, I shift back. It's the same thing as saying G55, and then at the end of the program, starting your next one, you go back into G54. It'd be the same thing here. At the end of my program, I'm gonna shift everything back to where I started. So that's really the difference between local coordinates and global coordinates. Swiss machines typically use the global coordinate system, whereas your conventional lathe is gonna use a local coordinate system. Both work just fine, just a little bit different animal.